Hey guys, this is Ryan. I am going to do a quick walkthrough of Project 1, the vehicle wrap project. And first off, let me just say a disclaimer for any of you folks who are watching on YouTube and don't have access to the files that I'm going to be talking about. I'm sorry. The folks in the class are taking this. They're taking this as part of a course that I'm teaching. They receive university credit for it. It's paid for, so I'm not free to just distribute the files. So I hope you understand. However, you can follow along by choosing your own artwork to work from, and that's, you know, use at your own risk. But I will demonstrate how to find your own blueprints to use as the artwork for your project if you want to follow along. Feel free, that'd be awesome. So anyway, let's get started. So again, this project is a vehicle wrap, and essentially you'll be designing your own wrap to go on a vehicle of your choice. And for the project, I have some files that I've provided, and they're at the size that we'll be using. Basically, the artboard is a letter size landscaped document. So anyway, to show you how to do that, I will open a file, and I'll show you how many of the options that I'm providing for my students, just to give you a range of what's going on here. So Command-O on a Mac, Control-O on a PC. Go to the zipped file that you've downloaded that has these files in them. I'm going to choose, for example, this Hummer H1 wagon. And if you know me, you'll know why. I'm actually building a Hummer H1 replica. So hey, when I'm done, it would be really awesome to wrap that project. So I will just click open and bring that, fit the artboard within the window. And as you see, it's right there. I've got, it's 8.5 by 11 landscape style. And I have a side layout, the opposite side, a front view, rear view, and top view. And it looks a little funny because this is an old file that I used that I had modified quite extensively. And so part of it's bitmapped and part of it is shapes that I created, and I did all of the editing in Photoshop. So I haven't normalized the photo or the image so it looks good. So apologies there, but you can kind of see what we're going to be working with. So after that, once you've opened the file, I will show you what to do next. First, I'm going to show those who have found their own images, and then we'll pick up at the same point and everybody will be following along doing the same thing. So I will tell you where to skip ahead here. Or if you decide that if you want to do your own vehicle in the future, just follow and watch, and I'll show you how to do that. So, using your own artwork, I will go to, in my web browser, in this case it's Google Chrome, and I will search this website, theblueprints.com. the-blueprints.com, pardon me. You can create an account. I have one already. We'll go with the blueprints database. You'll select your vehicle, motorcycle, truck, cars, buses, you know, whatever you want to do. I would suggest doing a car or a truck or a motorcycle because some other you know, vehicles may be a little bit more intense as far as the complexity. And for example, let's go to the Hummer, and I can scroll down. I know which one I'm looking for. This, you'll see, looks very similar to the one I have on my screen. And the reason is I use this, like I said, as my master to edit out all of these call-out points, the 242, the Bushmaster 50 cal, or whatever that thing is, humongous gun on top, and then also the turret and all of these, you know, other points, the jerry cans on the back, the radio antennas. I took all of those off because I wanted more of a civilian model of the Hummer, and this would actually be the Humvee, so it's just branded wrong. Anyway, so what you'll do is either save the file, and let me go back one page. If you're using this website, you can sort by dimensions. So for example, there's a sort by dimensions, and it will give you the highest resolution images near the top. So if I wanted a Hummer H3, here's one, and as you see, it's fairly high resolution. That ought to be fun if you're looking for one of the modern Hummer H3s. I actually prefer the H1. So just be careful, make sure that what you are looking at is accurate. And in this case, there are some mistakes with the artwork. But for the project, it really doesn't matter how accurate you're doing, because you're going to be creating a vector wrap. So whichever you prefer. And again, you don't have to choose a Hummer. You can choose whichever car you like. Say you drive a, like I do, a Plymouth Voyager minivan. So let's sort by dimensions and find on the screen a Voyager. I don't see one on this page that's what I'm looking for. 1984 Plymouth Voyager, there you go. That's really small, really low resolution. If you can't find one on this site, what you're looking for, and again, you'll want the blueprints. You'll want the raster image. All right, so let's skip the Plymouth Voyager. Go to, pick any car. So again, I'm gonna go with this Hummer. The 252 Bushmaster is my example here. And all you need to do is click that image to get the large version of it. And as you can see, it's fairly large. It doesn't even fit on my screen. And you can either prepare or download the file, or right click and copy image. You may want to save that image to your desktop or somewhere on your computer so you have it for future use. I'm going to show you just by copying, and then I'll go into Illustrator. And to make sure that I have the file that I want, the file size, I'm going to do Command N on a Mac, Control N on a PC, go with the Print Document Profile, choose the letter size, turn the orientation to landscape, and then click OK. And that should give you a blank artboard in a letter size landscape file. And then simply paste it by Command V on a Mac, Control V on a PC, and then I need to zoom way out. So Command minus, Control minus on a PC. And then I mention in my instructions, the instruction sheet that I email to my students, that you need to constrain your image so that it fits on that artboard. So I'm going to hold down Shift, and while I hold down Shift, I will grab this corner anchor, make sure that I have the direct or the selection tool, which is the black arrow up here. And if you need to find that, just click the V button, and that will get you the selection tool. Click on the image, hold down Shift, but if you've just pasted it, it should still be selected. So hold down Shift and drag this corner. If you click anywhere other than the corner, for example, while holding Shift, it will deselect. So maybe you want to select and start dragging first. And then after you've started to drag, while you are still holding your mouse button down, then hit Shift. And you want to constrain those dimensions so that it will remain congruent vertically and horizontally. And then I'm going to snap it to the edge of that artboard. And if you miss, it's okay. Just move it around until you get that intersect. Let me show you that again. I'll zoom in so you can see it. And that's Command plus to zoom in. And so I will just snap to that side and then snap to the bottom. You can see the intersect on my smart guides. And then I will zoom back out. Command minus, Control minus on a PC. Hold down the hand, or get the hand tool by holding down the space bar. And then, whoops, I did not mean to do that. And then hold down Shift, or start to drag that opposite angle, and then make sure to hold down Shift, and then constrain it so that it fits within the artboard. So what I'm talking about there is I've snapped the top and these two sides to the artboard, and then I can move just by sliding and holding down Shift while I drag it, and you can see the lines that I need to be concerned about, the lines of the vehicle itself, are within the artboard. So that's fine. If you would rather constrain it and make sure that all points are inside the artboard, you can do that. It'll make your image a little smaller, but it's vector art, so we're working with vector art as we create the wrap, so it won't really matter that much. So if you want to do that, drag holding Shift to constrain to that side, and then holding down Shift while you drag that opposite corner, and just make sure that all four sides, missed it there, are within the artboard. And if I zoom to fit the artboard in the window, or zoom out a little bit, you can see what I mean. It's all, the entire artwork is within the window. Okay. Before I go into the step where everybody else can follow along, another place that you can find images is simply go to Google or your web browser of choice and type in the make and model of the vehicle, and then type in blueprint afterward, or blueprints, and hit OK or enter, and then see if you can find images. And on Google, it will show those dimensions, or it will give you the option to show the dimensions of that, those the image sizes. So for example, I will do large, or larger than, let's do larger than 2 megapixels. So now you see all of these images, and it'll, if you hover over, you can see that there are, you can see the dimensions. So for example, if I would like this Lamborghini Countach right here, I could click that image and then simply view image to get the full size, and you can zoom in if you'd like, right click it, save it to your desktop or anywhere on your computer, or copy that image and do the same steps that I just showed you. So that would be one option you can do if you don't want any of the ones that I've provided. And again, let me show you which ones those are. I have a Nissan Skyline GTR, a Lamborghini Murcielago, the Hummer H1 wagon, a Ford Highboy, that's a 1932 hot rod, a Ford F-150 crew cab from this year, 2015, a Fiat Scudo Maxi van, 2007, and the body of that one is the same as the Ford Transit. So if you have a Ford Transit that you would like to wrap, go find the Fiat Scudo Maxi van, and that's the same body. It's a little bit different headlight style and bumper, but other than that, it's pretty much the same van. The Ducati 748 and 998, and that one has the it only had the image that I found only had one side, so I edited a little bit and gave you an opposite side. However, it's just a repeat of that first side. So your chain guard, your pulleys, and all of the axle issues are not going to be on both sides. You'll have different parts of the frame on the opposite side, but you're typically not going to be vinyl wrapping the chain and the pulleys and the axles and the frame. You'll only be doing the fiberglass or carbon fiber parts. So bear that in mind when you're doing this vehicle wrap project. I've got the 63 Chevy Impala Sport Sedan and a Chevrolet Express van from 2005. So I'll give you a couple of choices to choose from if you're using my files. If you're not, you've got the vastness of the internet to choose from. And again, if you follow the instructions that I used, that I just gave for with using this Hummer, this Humvee Bushmaster M242, then you should be able to constrain the size and fit it within the artboard that you need. Okay, so I am not going to save this one. I don't really want to use it right now, so I'm going to close that. However, I have this other one that I have started, or that I have created for my students, and this again is only available to the students in the class. The next step you're going to follow, whether you are downloading your own version or using one of mine, one of the files that I've provided, is you're going to want to lock, and this is a feature that is available in Illustrator Creative Cloud versions. However, I haven't seen it in the CS6 version, and in fact, when I was adding this as a part of the file, it didn't open in CS6. So if you have Creative Suite 6 or earlier, this may not work for you, but you can still do some of the things that I'll show you here. So go to your layers panel, and I have that on my my side here in my panels. It's this one that looks like two layers of paper. If you hover over, it says layers. If you want to find it, you don't see it, go to window, and click the layers panel option right here, which is also F7 on your keyboard. So when you click that, it just opens up. You have this layer, and your artwork should be posted on layer 1. If you've created a new document, this should be the same case. And then the thing that you will want to do if you are on CS6 or CS5 or an earlier version of Illustrator is just click near in this box next to the eye will turn on the visibility, and this box here you can toggle, and where's the highlight, it should say toggle this to lock your artwork. So essentially you can see that my layer has the pencil with the no symbol, so basically you can't edit artwork that's locked. So that's what we're going to do. We want to have a template that we can draw without destroying this artwork. Again, one thing I forgot to mention that I did put in my instruction sheet for my class, for my students, is that if you open one of the Illustrator files that I've provided and you want to start working with it, save it as a copy, save it somewhere else. Save it so that you have a file to go back to if you happen to destroy or edit beyond repair this file. Or just send me an email and I'll send it back to you. And again, that only goes for students in my live class. So you can either lock it with this button here, or what we're going to do is click anywhere on the layer name or the layer other than the name. If you click on, double click on the name, you will change the name. I really want you to double click anywhere else. I want you to double click anywhere else so that this layer options panel pops up, and you can click template if you're in Creative Cloud, which will automatically lock and dim the image to 50%, and I'll show you what that does. It just kind of knocked it down so that you can't, I mean, so the edges are visible, but they're down to 50% opacity, so you can draw your artwork. And for example, if you're using the default colors, well, of course it's locked right now, but I'll show you in just a second. The next thing you'll want to do before you start working is create a new layer, and that's this panel, or this part of the panel right here. It's a little icon that looks like a new page. So you click create new layer, and I'm going to double click in that layer and title it wrap so that I know that this is my wrap layer. And then I'm going to go ahead and use the pen tool, or whichever tool you prefer. If you prefer the brush, or excuse me, the pencil, because you're just creating lines, it probably be better to use the pencil. So what I will do is then start clicking around my vehicle, and as you can see, it'll fill, and I will not be able to see that. See the artwork eventually, because it becomes covered up by the fill. So I'm going to have to move things around. And if you haven't yet gone through my course, or excuse me, gone through my lessons on the pen tool or whichever tool you're interested in using, or you seem to have forgotten, since we discussed them in class, or you weren't there in class, or you're doing this online and you just found this video, I do have an introductory Illustrator course that I'm teaching. It is referenced on my YouTube channel, so you can watch those lectures or those lessons and basically wrap your vehicle. You'll want to make note, and as you see here, you can't see any of the windows, you can't see any of the doors, you can't see any part of the vehicle other than what I have wrapped. So if I want the windows to be cut out of the vinyl and, you know, have the logo not on the windows, I will want to make sure to cut out that part of my wrap. And so basically how I will do that and know where to cut is I will switch from the default colors down here. I will make sure that the fill is active, and right now it's not, so I will click X on my keyboard, and you'll know it's active because it'll be in front. Right now the stroke is active. I click X, the fill is active, and then I can hit the slash key, which brings the none for the no fill effect. So I will hit the slash to slash out the fill, and as you see, it took that out of the art that I had created. So let's pretend that I would like to have the driver window uncovered by the wrap, and maybe I want the rear passenger and the rear cargo area to be covered by the wrap. So that means I'll just create this shape to mask out the window there. And I'll show you what that'll look like. I can turn off the visibility of that rear layer, the template layer. I can turn it back on to see what it looks like, but when I turn it off, then I see this is my wrap, or at least what I've done so far. Okay, so what I want you to do is go around the vehicle, do any of the details that you would like to either highlight or wrap. For example, if you wanted a wrap to be a partial vehicle wrap, if you wanted the vehicle or the wrap to be a partial vehicle wrap, for example, that it only goes halfway up, that is a choice that you are able to make. And so then in that case, I would not have done any of those points, and I could have it coming up and stopping right there at the windows. And so then my wrap would look like this, except I wouldn't need this for the window because it's unnecessary. So if I only want to wrap the bottom of the vehicle, you know, that's an option. And just keep in mind what you want to do with your design. And then what I would like for you to do in my class is wrap the side, the opposite side, only if you want to do a different design there. You don't have to do the opposite side. I just put those in the files that I provided in case, for example, when we get to discussing text, you'll want text to be, let me just show you by example. Let's increase that size to 48, give it a nice deco look, something. Here we go. And so I have my awesome text that I'm going to put on the side of my Hummer. And on this side, it'll read just fine. However, if I just took these two parts and inverted them, whoops, that's not what I wanted to do. And so we'll talk about the transforming tools. So if I want to reflect it, double click on reflect, it brings up the reflect panel, and then I can make a copy of it in reverse. And as you see, if I want to put that on my Hummer, well, awesome is now backwards. So I don't want to do that. So I forgot to make a copy. So what I will want to do is when I reflect it, make sure that everything lines up to that opposite side. But then I want to take my text and I want to have it so it's legible. So it says awesome on both sides. Hopefully that makes sense why I gave you the option to do the opposite side. And then do the front and the back. And if there is a top and you want to put something on the top, for example, if I finish my wrap and I want to put awesome graphics all the way across the top, there it is. So that's pretty awesome. And we'll discuss all of these things as we go through the next couple of weeks the project. Just some notes, and I mentioned them in my instructions for my class. Do not use a vector image if you're trying to learn how to draw vectors, because it will do it for you and you won't really learn how to work with the vector tools. Also, not all vectors are created equally. You may have to tweak it, and you may get in over your head and not be able to create the look you're going for. So just be wary of that. Also, most vectors cost money. So if money's no object for you, go ahead and play with them. Go ahead and find a vector download of the vehicle that you're looking for. For my students, please don't use a vector download, because again, I'd much rather you learn the tools, because you're going to need to have that experience in your careers. Also, you may be tempted to use the image trace function, and that's one tool that we will discuss later in this class, but please don't use that for your wrap, because it may cause some unforeseen results, and that it can take not only more time and frustration to get them worked out, but you're also not learning how to use the pen tool, the pencil tool, the vector drawing tools that are available. Okay, so here is that. That was probably a little longer than I wanted to do, but it's the gist of what we're going to cover with this project. And get started, go have fun with it, and we'll keep up with your progress. And I think our due date is, I want to say, either the 15th of July, something like that. So a couple of weeks from now. Anyway, enjoy, and we'll see you later. Thank you.